Hello, this is Talia Andrews, and welcome to the UK edition of TDTV. The Caribbean island of Aruba witnessed an 8.7% year-on-year increase in UK arrivals for the first half of this year. Establishing itself as one of the top 10 Caribbean destinations for the British market, the island attracted 5,921 visitors between January and June 2010. More than 30 UK tour operators now feature the island, including Kooni, Thomas Cook Signature, Hayes & Jarvis, and LastMinute.com. The Turkish Culture and Tourism Office in the UK has advised British travellers that the destination is safe despite recent terrorist threats. Some 2.7 million visitors are expected to arrive in the country this year, a 12% rise from 2009. Turkish Culture and Tourism UK Office Director Irfan Önal told Travel Daily that the FCO only advises against travel to the remote areas of Hakkari, Cernak, Sirt and Tunçeli in southeastern Turkey, which is far removed from the country's tourism centres. ABTA estimates 1.9 million Britons will head overseas this weekend as holiday and tourism prices drop worldwide. Up to 440,000 passengers are expected to leave Heathrow, 250,000 from Gatwick and 127,000 from Edinburgh and Glasgow. The Cooperative Travel has revealed that family summer holiday prices have fallen by 34% compared to last year. Eurostar has seen a 6% rise in passenger numbers and 18% revenue increase during the first half of this year. The rail service carried 4.6 million passengers and generated more than £400 million, a figure which was boosted by the April ash cloud chaos. Eurostar Chief Executive Nicholas Petrovic said the company had seen strong growth in both business and leisure bookings. And finally, the Dubai Marriott Harbour Hotel and Suites has revitalised its spa service. Drawing on age-old customs, the Sarai Spa practices ancient healing techniques. Featuring a wide range of therapies, the spa boasts 6 individual treatment rooms, tranquil indoor relaxation areas, showers, a steam room, sauna and a jacuzzi. That's it for today. Thanks for watching the UK edition of TDTV. We'll see you again next week.